So here's the structure that you see when you open up the accounting software in the embedded web server. This is the embedded web server. This is the IP address of my printer. And this is the accounting. Now, how many things show up in here you can set elsewhere to determine how many jobs you want to retain at one time. You can also set access to this and security for this, like some people can't come in and delete things. So this is your front panel, and these are showing you each job. If I were a production manager, I'd want to know things, and I was back in the day. I want to know things like cancel by user. Well, what does that mean? Well, that means the job didn't get done. So why is it being canceled? All these canceled jobs add up to quite a bit of money. Also, it suggests that maybe jobs weren't prepared properly or there were mistakes done. Also, then you have here under cost assignments. For me, I have 775 milliliter ink, and I factor in an all consumable price of $165. Then you can go into your media and you put in the width, put in the length, and you put in the price. That's going to calculate along with it. Then you have fixed costs. So let's say it's, I don't know, $10 for a fixed cost. That's your load and unload. You put all this together and then it transfers back to the accounting. And as soon as you change this and hit apply, it recalculates all the jobs. So just to give you an idea, this one down here, Simon Crop, this was a print that I did, and I already know that this print was a very heavy coverage. I mean, it was a big, rich, giant photographic image with a lot of heavy ink. So it's going to run on the high side. But what's most important to me isn't so much over here, the cost of the ink, which is all consumables. The thing that concerns me the most is over here. Now, I already know that this job was 10.7 square feet. Huh, so why is it calculating it as 15.6 square feet? That's because the use of the image was not efficient to the width of the material. And to some degree, I had some waste. So when you look at this, what you want to keep in mind is the size of the actual image is the right calculation. What you have here is linear square feet. So this is calculating a 36-inch roll, I believe, that goes linearly. And I have some room on the edges. Now, if you make total efficient use of your particular image on the size of the media, which I always recommend anyway, then those will be very accurate. But I need you to know that. I need you to be aware of it. The other thing that probably happened with that, which almost certainly did, is it calculated in the calibration charts that I did. So the ink price seems really high. Well, the reason it seems high is because I have a chart that I run which determines, you know, what density to choose. And then I ran several calibration charts, and all of those charts have to go somewhere. Well, they get put into the first job you run after you create them. So this is the first job I ran afterwards, which means it's not the right size. It padded everything with all of this extra stuff, and it made my cost per copy seem, cost per square foot seem a lot higher than it really was. So those are they're just little quirks in here, and I just need to be clear about them so that you can help calculate your costs accurately. One is the way it applies your calibration charts to the first print you do. If I run Simon Crop 2 again, Simon Crop 2 is going to have very, very different ink cost. And then also be aware that if you're not running totally efficient across the media, you're going to have extra square footage tacked on, which can distort your price. At the end of the road, I take the whole thing out to Excel. This is a nice visual, but Excel's a much better way to calculate things, export the whole thing into an Excel sheet, and then I can break down all my costs. Again, we are real, dead-on, soup-to-nuts cost. There's no estimation. It's not guesswork. We make this very easy for you.